Hello and welcome to Build. I'm Sam Thompson and today I'm joined by a very special guest. Please put your hands together for Moo.
Hi guys.
She is here to talk about her new album, Forever Neverland, which drops tomorrow. I'm very excited. Now, before we get started, though, if anyone here is watching on Facebook Live, all you have to do is leave a question below and we will answer them, or just tweet us at BuildSeriesLDN. Now, Moo, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
How much are you enjoying the UK?
It's really nice being here. It's always great to be here.
It's so good to have you. I'm trying not to be starstruck. I really, really am, but it's hard.
Come on.
Could you tell us a little bit about your new album that is dropping tomorrow?
Well, yeah. I mean, I can't believe it's coming tomorrow. Like, it's been 4.5 years writing it. So I'm like, oh, is this really happening? You know, it's my second album. They all say the second one is the hard one. And I was like, no, that's not true. It's going to be easy. Ugh, whatever. And then it took forever. So I'm like so happy to finally have my baby fly, you know, tomorrow.
And there it is. We've actually got a clip of one of the songs, Sun in Our Eyes. We're going to show it now.
Right.
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, I've never seen the video where it's like that detailed, like in that way. Yeah, I was like, whoa.
It's amazing though. How fun was that to film?
It was pretty fun. It was really nice because again, like, you know, obviously the title Forever Neverland is like referring to the whole tale about Peter Pan. You know, people that don't want to grow up. And so we wanted to do with this video, make it like this boat of like people choosing to like, fuck off society. We're going to build our own thing, you know. So
love that. Were you really hands-on with the making of the video, or did you have a director sort of doing their thing?
I had a director, but we talked about the concept leading into the album and this kind of idea of creating your own utopia, even though you may know it might be just like an illusion.
I like that. We have ballroom dancing on a boat as well. That's pretty darn cool.
Yeah, I love that.
Who's a better dancer, you or Diplo? Because I saw him in that as well.
I think we're both very passionate dancers, but maybe not the most trained dancers, you know?
I saw the other video, the music video.
Oh, yeah, right. That was amazing.
You guys are throwing each other all over the place in that one.
Yeah, I mean, we were both trying really hard, and I think we did an okay job.
So you speak about living in a bubble and imaginary love in this new album.
Right.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, I think for Sun in Our Eyes, like, and Imaginary Friend, it's this thing of, like, being in love with the idea of being in love. But I think in general for the album, it's more this discussing this whole thing about escapism. Is that what you say? You know, again, we live in a time where it's like we're all escaping into our phones and like it's all about your own little narcissistic, like, you know. And that's totally our times right now. And I think it's easy, even with, you know, politics going very right now, everything, there's all these things happening. It's easy to just be like, oh, let's just not think about it.
Escape into your phones, basically, like, and sort of not look about what's going on
exactly.
in the world.
Exactly. But I think that's why I chose the title, because it's also kind of ironic, because you know you can't escape. You cannot just deny reality forever. That would be really dumb and really dark, actually. So I think that's kind of the theme, you know.
And imaginary love, I know, what's the difference then between imaginary love and real love?
Well, real love, you have to deal with, you know, real life problems
I'm
in a relationship.
Learning.
No, but you know, but when it's just like this thing where you're like, oh, it could have been great. Oh, I wish, you know, then it's like, you know, it's great because you don't have to deal with what it would actually be like if you were in a relationship, you know.
I know, exactly. So way down as well, that you were talking about politics and stuff.
Yeah.
That actually is the sort of, you're talking about the politics in that song, aren't you?
I mean, basically, I wrote the song, a little bit after Trump was elected, but, you know, me just having this fear of, oh, my God, like, is the whole world going to go up in flames? What's going to happen, you know? Because, you know, it was kind of a shock that he got elected.
I'm imagine. So, yeah, and it's like semi-apocalyptic, isn't it?
Yeah, it's definitely apocalyptic, yeah.
Oh, God, we're all going down. We're going down. But the thing is, you know, you have to talk about... It's so amazing how you can speak about all these things that come straight into your head and it's so genuine. Is there a way sort of that you get yourself out of that negative headspace sometimes if it becomes too much? And what do you do to sort of like create that positivity?
Well, I mean, I think writing songs and being in a creative flow is a very positive feeling. Even if you are, for instance, with Way Down, talking about this fear of what's going to happen with the future. It's, for me, I think it's a positive way of dealing with those things that you're scared of or negative feelings, because you create something and that's a great feeling, you know.
And that's for you, isn't it? Music is sort of your, not escapism, but that's just what you love.
Yeah, it's what I love. It's positive. It's a positive space, you know. And again, I always think that thing about being in a flow, like doing something you like, that's like giving likes to yourself. Like, you know, just, yay, I'm great, you know.
Can I just ask, what is it like to work so closely with Diplo?
Well, I mean, you know, I've worked with him now for many years on many projects and songs, and I mean, it's just like working with a friend.
A best mate.
Yeah, it's like just because it's just fun, you know, and we know, you know, each other really well. And I think every time he puts something on, like a beat or something, I'm always like, oh, it's so great. It's so next level. And so, I mean, I think it's, I mean, I've been so blessed and so privileged to get to work with him so much, because he is really one of the front moving creatives of our time, I think.
Yeah, for sure. But he's had some really good praise for you. He says that every time they get into the studio, it's not just one song that they bang, it's three or four, okay, in one day. And he said that you guys just, you work so well together. That's pretty high praise. I'm a pretty darn good man.
Yeah, he's sweet.
Yeah, he most certainly is. Now, you've done so many amazing collaborations with so many people, okay? Is there anyone that you would like to do that you haven't worked with so far?
Oh, it's a tough question, because I feel like nowadays there's so many cool up-and-coming artists, and obviously there's so many awesome established artists, and so it's like, it's not like there's just one that I'm like, oh, it's just this one. There's many.
Let's say three. And okay, let's make it more fun.
Okay.
Dead or alive. Oh. It can be dead or alive.
Okay. Leonard Cohen.
Okay, fair play.
Yeah. And then Caesar? Caesar. How do you say that? Caesar? S-C-A? Caesar. Yeah, right.
Okay, I thought you were going to say Julius Caesar. And I was like, wow, fair play. I like that. No. Out of nowhere.
And then Kurt Cobain.
Yeah, love that. Three very, very good picks there. Now, you're going on a tour,
right,
aren't you?
Yes.
Now, look, I know you're a good live singer, because I'm going to be honest, I've watched loads, but but how do you... You must still get nervous for those things, right?
I do, especially if it's, like, really big shows or, like... Actually, always when I play in London, I'm very nervous, because, you know, it's London.
We love you.
No, but just, I get nervous. And I thought that, you know, because I've been touring and playing many shows over the years, but I just still get, like, that... And it's so annoying, but, I, you know, we just learned... Before we come in,
the power starts, like everybody. This. So if you do that for a few minutes, yeah, it makes you feel powerful.
Yeah. So I'm going to start doing that after each show, I think.
So will I. That's what we bonded over just then. Yeah. Pretty darn cool. Where's your favorite place so far to perform? Where have you felt that energy where you're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this is happening?
That's really, it's a really tough question, because it can happen anywhere. That feeling of just, you know, it's all about the energy in the room and just, you know, yeah.
Like that?
Exactly, like that, for instance.
And okay, look, apparently, well, not apparently, we're seeing it right now, you are not adverse to a little stage dive.
Yeah, no, I do that all the time.
A crowd surf, if you will. How do you gee yourself up for that?
I mean, it's something I've been doing since 2013. It's just like such a nice ending of the show, like such a good little kick, you know, to just, you know, and also it's a way to unify the room, like, oh, we're all like, you know, and so I really love that. And I, you know, of course, sometimes it's harder to get into the crowd, like getting up there, like than it is other times. But I have like a, what do you say, like what do you call it? You know, like a way to find out, like, where can I do it?
Routine.
Routine, that's the word.
Boom, there we go. We're in sync. It's fine. Don't worry about it.
But so, you know, like always I like look for someone like they can carry me these... You know, they're strong enough to carry me. And then I, like, reach out my hand and do, like, this thing with my eyes. And then I, like, slowly, like, get out there.
It's scary though, because you just get dropped.
Yeah, but I mean,
have you ever been dropped?
Yeah.
Oh, she's been dropped. No way.
But then it's like kind of like a fun thing, because then you're already out there and it's like, oh, okay, you know. It's fun.
Where was that?
No, it happens sometimes.
Really?
Yeah, from time to time. Oh. But that's fine. I mean, again, I don't expect them to carry me.
I can't imagine it will ever happen again. I really can't. I would put in every strength I had, literally. But and I'm pretty sure everyone counts them pretty lucky as well to do that. You're finishing the tour in your hometown as well.
Yes.
That's pretty special.
Yeah, it is. I'm going to be really, really nervous for that one.
I can imagine. Now, what song? Do you think about this? Like, what song do you start with? What song do you finish with?
Yeah, we have now, and again now with the new album coming out and all the new tracks, so we have actually planned out the whole track list. No, set list.
Really?
Yeah, but I mean, again, actually, you never know whether it's going to work until you're out there and you're like, you're seeing the crowd and you feel like how they're reacting to it, you know? So we'll see. We might change it up on the go, on the tour.
Yeah, I like that. Just, you know, just on the fly. Why not?
Yeah.
Is there any song that you're actually like, especially looking forward to? Like, you can't wait to get it out there to the people?
I mean, the song that I just released a couple of days ago, Blur, is a song that means a lot to me. So I'm really happy that that's out. And I mean, I think just in general, I'm just really excited for people to hear the whole work, like in at the same time. Fuck, I don't know what you call it, like, you know, cohesively.
I understand what you're saying.
Good. Okay, great. Well,
4 years though.
Four and a half years
to create an album.
Yeah.
I don't know much about that kind of world, but that is a lot of work to put in.
It is a lot of time. I mean, I will say though, the oldest song on the actual album is not more than 2 years old, but like the making, like I started writing on it in theory, you know, like writing songs, but they didn't end up on it. Two years is the oldest.
Is there anything on the album that hasn't made the album that you kind of wish had, or?
No.
Everything's
been
on there.
But it's just like, it's been like such a long process, and I'm like super perfectionistic, and like I've made, I don't know, maybe 200 songs, and you know, there's been so much consideration going into this process. So with the actual songs that ended on it, I mean, of course I'm nervous. Maybe, of course I'm like, maybe someone would have liked these songs better, but the ones that we ended up picking for the actual album are the ones that I feel like should be there.
Now, Moo, you're getting a lot of love on the socials, okay? We got Ola on Facebook. She asks, which song on the album is the most personal to you?
They're all pretty personal, but I will say the most personal one is the one called Trying to Be Good.
What's that about?
It's about that
trying to be good.
but it's about that thing of being sick of trying to constantly be good, you know, and people wanting put you into a box, like fitting a certain mold, and you don't feel like you fit into it, and you're just like, fuck this. I'm so fucking tired of trying to fit into this or trying to be this person you think that I am, but which I'm clearly not. So I just want to be myself and not just do my thing, you know.
Do you feel like in the industry, that's really interesting to me, in the industry you have to maybe be this person that you're not to maybe climb that ladder?
Right. I think sometimes there can be an undertone of that sometimes. But I mean, it's up to yourself to be the one to say, no, I know what I want, you know?
Yeah, exactly. And do you feel maybe that, you know, I feel like your lyrics are so powerful.
Thank you.
And you know, you talk about sort of being a strong woman and feminism sometimes and do you think that maybe in the industry nowadays, that's kind of the done thing and people are sort of almost watering down the message?
Watering down the message? What does that mean?
Sort of, they're doing it because they know it will sell and they don't actually mean it.
Right. I mean, you know what? Whatever reasons people have to preach about feminism, for instance, is like, I mean, if it reaches out to an audience or a younger audience and help them understand and just get some kind of education about what this is, then I think that's good. I think it's important to speak up. And even if there's maybe, you know, a marketing plan behind it, you know, I'm still like, it's good for young people or for whatever people.
Get it out there.
To get it out there, yeah.
Absolutely. Now, we've got another question on the socials. Natasha on Facebook as well. Will there be any live sessions for the album, just like with your previous EP, When I Was Young?
Right. Well, there's nothing officially planned right now, but maybe. Because I love doing those kind of things. So we will see. I don't know.
You must have been so hectic getting this album ready for release and then working so hard. One, you must need a rest. Two, do you have anything really big and special planned for 2019? Or have you not looked that far ahead yet?
Wait, what? What was the last thing you said?
That you've obviously worked really hard.
Oh, yeah.
Possibly need a break.
Yeah, well, not right now. It's not going to happen right now.
Still going.
Yeah, I think I'm going to maybe take a vacation next year sometimes, but it's fine. Seriously, again, like, I've been so excited for this moment, for this album to finally come out. I'm still like, I can't believe that it's actually happening. So I'm like, I can work for a half a year without taking any break, I guess.
And have you got plans for 2019? Like, no. some really big ideas that you want to push through?
Oh, like work stuff, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's. I think I'm going to be touring a lot, of course. I love touring, and, you know, now with the album out. And then, I mean, there's lots of things that I'm hoping for and planning for, but it's all, like, kind of like, we'll see, you know, and it's in the making, blah, 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 you know.
Anything that you can tell us right now?
No. No, tour. Lots of tours and lots of new things.
Well, Moo, thank you so, so much for being here. Unfortunately, we are out of time. That has gone so, so quickly. Guys, can you please put your hands together one more time for Moo?
Hi, guys.
Her new album, Forever Neverland, is dropping tomorrow. I will be buying it. I suggest you guys do too. I've been Sam Thompson. Thank you so much for watching.